to me for all the blessings that I cannot see.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. With a grateful heart, with a song of praise, with an outstretched arm,
Father, we just thank you for today, Lord. Thank you for all of us meeting together, Father. We just want to thank you for this new day you've given us. Thank you for your mercies, which are new every morning. And Father, we pray that you will be with us as we all come together and listen to the word that you put on my heart, Father, in Jesus' name. Amen. I was putting up my heart to, for Thanksgiving, giving thanks to God, the power of grateful prayers. And then a friend of mine actually forwarded this to me. So I'm great. And that really blessed me. So I thought I'd share this with you all. It's the power of grateful prayers. It's from Philippians 4, verses 6 to 7. I'll read that because I'm not good in sharing my screen. So I'll read that out. Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. So in this verse, we find one of the most difficult verses in the entire Bible to obey, because it says, don't worry about anything. Instead, pray about everything and tell God what you need and thank him for all that he has done. If we do this, we are told we will experience God's peace. Actually, it's not easy to stop worrying about the often scary parts of our lives, but God tells us how in the next part of the verse, pray about everything and then thank him for all that he has done. And grateful prayers brings peace. Parents actually understand the power of grateful prayers. Most parents think wouldn't appreciate if the children just kept making requests without saying thank you for what they have already received. God sees it in the same way. He wants us to ask him what we need and want. More than 20 times in the New Testament, we are told, ask him. But the Lord wants us to ask with gratefulness. The Bible urges us to be specific in our requests. Instead of a simple thank you for everything, he wants us to tell him what we are grateful for. So when we pray, we can tell God what we are thankful for. Prayer is one of the most important ways to tell God thank you. So today we can, what are we thankful for? We can ask this about ourselves. We can ask this question. Why do we think gratitude is so important for our spiritual lives? That's the one question we can ask. Or being as specific as possible, for what are we thankful to God? We can spend some time in prayer thanking God for those things. And what are some of the ways we believe God will bless us in the future? Amen. We can be thankful to God for one thing God has done for us.
Okay, so if you to start responding in prayer, unmute yourselves. One thing that we're grateful for. Start with one, and I'm sure we'll go from there.
Yes, oh yeah, plenty. Sometimes we feel faithless, but you always remain faithful. Thank you, Father, for a faithful friend you are. And Lord, we just thank you for giving us this beautiful day. Thank you for the sunshine that is shining on us today. So we just thank you for the new day you've given us, Lord. Help us, Lord, to walk today on the path that you have already ordained for us to walk. In Jesus' name, amen.
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 Amen.